All right, so after learning how to calculate the binding energy of every nucleus, we can start making some graphs. And often I'd get students to do this. We don't have much time left, but I'd make you use a spreadsheet, and you would then have to then look at calculating the binding energy of about 30 or 40 different nuclei in the periodic table. Okay, and you'd graph it. So if you were just looking at binding energy by looking at the mass defect of every atom, what you would find is not this graph that I have presented over here. You would find that if you graphed it, I'm going to just draw it a little bit below. Okay, so if I graphed just binding energy versus the nucleon number, if we did that for the entire periodic table, you would find that the graph ends up looking something like that. It's always going to increase. As I add nucleons, the binding energy is going to increase. But it doesn't increase linearly. It doesn't keep going straight up, or it doesn't go exponentially. It starts to go in that direction, which means that as I get further and further up and I start adding nucleons, they're not adding as much binding energy every time that they go in. And then the nucleus is becoming less and less stable because there's less binding energy over here than that rapid rise in binding energy at the beginning. So that's not really a useful graph. It's a graph that we can understand that, okay, the binding energy goes up and it doesn't really go up linearly. But if I convert this graph by, say, instead of doing binding energy alone, but taking the binding energy divided by the nucleon number of an element, which is this graph over here, the binding energy divided by the number of nucleons in each element, the graph transforms itself into something that looks like this, a different shape. Okay, and we can see that at, you know, before element 60 over here, the binding energy per nucleon increases. And remember I told you guys that iron 56 is the most stable nucleus there is because it's at the top of that peak. Iron 56 has the highest binding energy per nucleon in its nucleus, about 8.6 mega electron volts per nucleon is iron. Okay, so all these elements on this side of the periodic table, they want to keep adding nucleons so that they become as stable as iron. And then after I get past iron, these elements like uranium, they're not as stable as iron. They want to break apart slowly, okay, undergo different nuclear decay reactions so that they can slowly increase the binding energy per nucleon. So how to understand this table is on the right-hand side of iron, elements break apart. They undergo fission. And on the left-hand side of this table, elements add to each other and they fuse together in the sun to become more stable. Okay, fission on that side, fusion on that side. Okay, and this curve is very useful for me to find the binding energy of any element. So how would I go and find the binding energy, the actual binding energy, not the binding energy per nucleon of iron. I want to find the binding energy of iron. So the binding energy of iron can be calculated by taking binding energy per nucleon times the total number of nucleons is equal to binding energy. Okay, so it's pretty easy. So often you're going to be given this graph on an exam, and they want you to calculate the binding energy using the graph. Well, all you'd have to do is take what you read on this side, like 8.8 mega electron volts, multiply it by 56, and that'll give you the total binding energy of that nucleus.